This is us, Agile Latvia. So I have a couple of guys here hiding. Jānis.
Hello, good morning.
What do you do in Agile Latvia?
Do not interesting stuff with papers, everything.
Okay, paper pusher. Okay.
Hi.
What's your name?
I'm Irini. You know what?
Ah. Nice. And you came here from where?
From Moscow, Russia.
That's nice. And why? Why? Tell us why. I'm so curious why.
Just to help the brilliant people to do the best event of this year.
That's nice. Round of applause, everyone.
And super. One note about that lady. She's a fantastic drawer. So all the drawings on the walls around that you see, that's big thanks to that lady. So let's give an applause.
Actually, they finished, I think, around 11 yesterday, something like
12.
That. 12. Oh, crazy. Okay, so that's us. Big thanks to our sponsors. We have two gold sponsors this year, Accenture for Finance. So they actually provide financing because the ticket for you is much less expensive than it actually costs to get one person through the conference. So it's just because of these guys. Accenture for Finance. Of course, Scrum Alliance is important to mention, so they help as well. From a local market, and not just local, we have Tieto and Exigent Services. So they are contributing a little bit as well to our cause, so that's nice. There are a lot of information sponsors, the guys that spread the word, send information everywhere, prepare press releases and stuff like that. So I'm especially proud about this icon. Do you know who it is? Any guesses? Just shout. No one knows what those smiley faces mean.
I don't even know what is that.
it's a proud community of Agile Estonia. So.
All right. Anyone from Estonia, by the way?
I think so. There should be a couple of guys.
Oh. Three people, yeah.
Awesome. All right. So, I would like to give a couple of words to Evolution Gaming. Ruslan, you wanted to advertise us, right? A little bit?
Yes. A little bit. So, five hours. So, 5 hours is a minimum. Time I need for a good speech. So I'm Ruslan Tarasovs from Evolution Gaming. We are general sponsors of this stuff, and we are general sponsors because we really, really believe in Agile. We really believe it works for us and might work for you also, and we want to like spread the word about it. But the thing I wanted to tell you about is that for each of us comes a day when you have to select to do a complex choice of between the two things about making your life more challenging or easier, between a challenge and between an easy stuff. And there is nothing inherently wrong about having an easy life and choosing easy for God's sake. If you want to do things easier and make your life easier, select and choose this thing for you. And actually, it is a lot of things in Agile is about making your life easier. So I don't see anything really, really wrong in this. But I believe that the Agile guys who did not go to retirement, they usually prefer to select something challenging for them. So because when you have a challenge, you evolve as a person, and the bigger the challenge is, unless it breaks you down, unless it kills you, it makes you a better person. So As we are general sponsor and it is a bit a shameless recruitment speech, I wanted to offer something really challenging for the guys that hear us. And what could be a challenge nightmare for an agile professional, for an agile coach, for a scrum master? So I thought about various stuff that people usually afraid of, like non-motivated lazy team, the guys who do not want to work, micromanaging product owner, the organization which does not want to change, a lot of such stuff. But actually, I thought that this is easy thing. This is easy thing for an agile professional, for any kind of IT professional who is used to make a lot of decisions every day. It is easy thing. Why it is easy? Because if you have a wolf or a lion running for you to eat you, you don't think, you don't have to make decisions. Your life is easy. You run, you just run. And this is what Scrum Masters and Agile guys, they are very used to do. If they have a bad team, if they have a bad product owner, if they had a bad organization, they change it. They talk about it every day. They know how to do it. They know how to motivate, how to add internal motivation into the guys, how to make them happier and make their life easier. What is the most challenging nightmare from my perspective for the guys? Not that. Not bad guys. Not bad companies where you have no budget to do anything. The worst possible nightmare for a agile professional, from my perspective, is successful company, a very successful company with high margins, with very professional guys already achieving a success. These guys usually do not want to change. They do not want to change. And when you come to them and tell them, guys, you are not efficient, you are wasting your time and your lives, they will say to you, we are already successful. We are already delivering our stuff. Why are you teaching us to work? And the real question is really, why do we have to teach these kind of guys how to work? And I would say that efficiency and success, it is an infinite thing. You can achieve more. And it is really, really, really hard to make the successful guys achieve more. And the message that I wanted to give you, that we as a company, this kind of nightmare, and we are waiting for you to join us. Thank you.
Thank you, Ruslan, for your honesty. I think it's the first time I see someone in power that's been so honest about shameless recruitment speeches and tough work in their organization. So I know firsthand, luckily or unfortunately, I'm not sure yet, but yeah, I work with Ruslan every single day, so. All right. So a lot of text here. The important thing to mention is that we on purpose actually, well, not on purpose, but was really hard to figure out a mechanism how to give you guys a chance to split between the tracks. So we're gonna imply a very simple mechanism, first come, first serve. So if you come to the session late, everything is, all the seats are taken, sorry. You can either stand or you can sit on the floor, it's your choice. But you can also go to other session that's not fully filled in yet, all right? Make sense? Yes, okay, I heard one yes.
Yes.
That's good enough.
Can you repeat, please? I'm just...
No. Yeah, okay. All right. So, in that corner, everyone looks there now because I'm showing there. Excellent. So, I see the coaching word written there. So, it's a corner where you go and ask any question that you like. I mean, one, why the sunrise is on the east, right? Is it?
And there is a simple game. If you feel like giving questions, you come and get a large sticky and put on your badge. And you will see people with large sticky will give you advice. Also, not only in the corner, anywhere. And the small sticky, put it on the badge, and then you will see, okay, that's a person willing to have answer on the question. And give, catch him, if he is drinking coffee, then stop him and give him advice. But actually, coaches shall not give advice, they shall ask questions. Make sure you read the rules of coaching.
Sorry. All right, so if you want to help someone, go there as a coach and help others. If you have a question, go there and get your answers. And yeah, what else do we have? Well, there will be a little bit of the lottery at the end of the day. So right after the closing keynote, there will be some prizes from Evolution Gaming for those that visited the stand. And yeah, the important thing.
The second day, first time ever, we have 2 days. So in order for us to understand how many you will be coming, there is an opposite side of registration table. You're welcome to put your plus sign if you're coming tomorrow so that we can count, and please do so before lunch. All right, so, and this open space will be on the second floor, not here, but on the second floor tomorrow. And yes, we will have large scale Lego workshop and also coaching clinic in parallel as well tomorrow.
But Ivo is showing there, but it actually over there.
It's
on the second floor. So use the stairs that are next to the registration right now,
yeah,
and
but
go
please,
to the second floor.
Please sign up on that wall with a marker. Just put a plus if you're coming tomorrow. Yeah.
Yes. So the reason for this is we don't want to waste any resources, right? So we need to order food for lunch for tomorrow. So we need to know how many people are coming, and we have a plan B as well, in case everyone decides to go to Jurmala or somewhere else. So stay tuned for that.
Plan B, Jurmala is in open space tomorrow. So.
Why not? I mean, we are ready. All right. So that was what we were talking so long about, right?
Yeah, let's just...
One more time, don't forget to sign up and put your plus there. The lunch break is in a big restaurant that is kind of... there, so you just exit the Algova and go to the left a little bit, and then you enter it. So just use your badge to show that yes, I'm part of this. I'm not just imposter or stranger from the street that came here just to eat, not get knowledge, right? And yeah, there is of course for those of you that want to certify as a with Scrum Alliance or PMI Institute. So you can use this conference for that purpose, to collect educational points. So I think that's nice. There is always more things to learn. Now the tricky part. So I'm not sure if this will work out. This is something new, again, I'm going to try with you today. The idea is that after each session, we need somehow to give our speakers a feedback. What do we think about the session, right? So most of us hopefully have a sticker. Who doesn't have a sticker with a Adair logo on it? Raise your hand if someone doesn't have it. That's fine. I will explain why. So the format will be always the same. So after each session, we will give you a couple of minutes to discuss the session in three persons, right, in trios. So you just take persons sitting next to you, and you discuss it, okay? You see, what did you like, what you didn't like, maybe what you think should be improved. And you together, in trio, you select one sticky that would say green if you think all three of you that session was awesome, right? Session was okay-ish, then you go yellow. And you can show your badge, because it's red, like this, if session wasn't that great. And then we take a photo of you doing this. And this is our feedback, right, that we can then give to our speakers so they can see what's going on. So there is one learning in this that I would like to take, or to give to you, hopefully. I don't know. I already taken it in. So every meeting is a workshop. And that is what we are trying to do here. Because when you just receive information, it's very little information that you get. But when you discuss it, you start to understand it, right? And when you need to make some decision in regards to this information, you receive it even more. So this is what we're trying to do here with this. We try to involve you more so it doesn't become a very boring, like, eyes closing conference, right? Okay. Excellent. So, should we try it? I think we should do a dry run. We have, we went over time a little bit, but we can spare 3 minutes for this. So, I'm gonna give you 3 minutes now to discuss it, this opening interviews, and then after 3 minutes I will count 3 to 1 and you're gonna show you your vote. All right? Good? 3 minutes starts now. All right, so time's up. Are we ready? So, on 3 to 1, right? So, 3, 2, 1, show your stickies. Everyone was shy to show red. Ah, there are a couple of guys not hiding there. All right, awesome, awesome. There more? Excellent. Okay, thank you very much. I think that worked out better than I expected, actually. So.